see the application of conservation of energy. Means one form of energy is converted to another form of energy. We'll see this application with the help of a simple pendulum. So let us consider a bob which is tied to a thread and from a rigid support. Okay, it is at a mean position. It is at rest at a position A. Slowly I pull to a side, and it means the bob has come here. The pendulum is here to position B and released. So this is the position B, and I have released it. Then it starts moving, it comes back to position A and moves towards position C. Clear? So this is position C. It moves like this and then it comes back. So it makes to and fro oscillations now. So this is the case of simple pendulum. So initially it is at rest. So we move to our side, the extreme position, and we release it. So it started oscillations, moving to and fro from the mean position. So at mean position, the height is zero. If you clearly see, there is a height h at position B and at position C. Okay, both are at same height, almost same. So it changed. Let me change this clearly. Same height. Okay. So now the body A, the pendulum is moving from position A to B and B to A and then A to C and C to A, again back A to B. So it's moving like this. Going to B, coming back from B to A and then moving to A to C and then coming back from C to A. Listen carefully. When it was moving, one form of energy is converted to another form of energy. Here height h is equal to 0. H is equal to 0 at position A. It's very clear from the picture. So when height is equal to 0, your potential energy U is equal to mgh. If you substitute the value of h, then you will get it will be mg into 0. So your potential energy is 0 at position A. Potential energy is 0. Then your kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Clear? So potential energy is 0 and your kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. And what about this position? Your potential energy is maximum and this is equal to mgh at position B. And listen carefully, when the body is moving from A to B, it stops momentarily, it stops a second and moves back. So it's moving like this. Stops a second and then comes back and then moves to the C position. Again it comes back. Yeah, this is the position of simple pendulum. It's moving like this. Okay. So in this movement, when it moves from the mean position, this is the mean position, center one, it goes to the extreme part, stops there momentarily for a few seconds, fraction of seconds, and then comes back. Again, it stops for a fraction of a second and then comes back. So, as it was stopping at the extreme positions, its velocity is zero. So, your kinetic energy will be zero. Same here also. It has a height h. So, your potential energy is equal to mgh and your kinetic energy is equal to zero at extreme position. At mean position, potential energy is 0. It's very clear, students. Listen carefully. Here, the potential energy is maximum and your kinetic energy is 0. Slowly, the potential energy decreases from position B to C. When it is coming back from extreme to mean position, its height is decreasing. You can see. Its height is decreasing and finally becoming 0. So your potential energy from maximum, it was becoming to 0. So potential energy slowly decreasing. Potential energy slowly decreasing from B to A. It's very clear. Then this potential energy, after decreasing, it is becoming to 0 at a point A. It means the potential energy decreasing and the same amount of energy is converted into kinetic energy. Your kinetic energy increases during this path. Listen carefully, students. When it moves from here, from A to B, its potential energy increases as it was achieving a high H. Okay? So, its potential energy increases. When it is coming back, its potential energy slowly decreases. It means your potential energy is slowly converted to kinetic energy in this part. Potential energy is converted to kinetic energy. What happening this way, B to A? Your kinetic energy is converted to potential energy. Then move on to C side, this side. From here, A to C. Again here also it achieved a high H. So your kinetic energy, your maximum kinetic energy, okay, at position A. So your kinetic energy slowly converts to, becomes zero and converts to potential energy. And this, when it is coming back, your potential energy is converted to kinetic energy. When they are coming from a height H to mean position, height is decreasing slowly on either side. Therefore, your potential energy slowly decreases and converts into kinetic energy. So, kinetic energy is maximum and potential energy is zero here. Kinetic energy is maximum and potential energy is zero. Very clear at mean position. Now, from here it was moving to the extreme position. Here it is kinetic energy is more. Potential energy is zero because height is zero. Potential energy slowly increases as height increases when the bomb moves from mean position to extreme position. When it is moving to the extreme position, height increases. So, kinetic energy is converting into potential energy. It's very clear from simple pendulum that one form of energy is converted into another form of energy. Your kinetic energy is converted to potential energy when moving back. Potential energy is converted to kinetic. And from here, kinetic energy to potential energy, coming back, potential energy to kinetic energy. So, one form of energy is converting into another form of energy. Anywhere in between these two positions, it contains both kinetic energy and potential energy. But at all positions, total energy will be constant. Total energy will be constant at any point as we saw it earlier. But one form of energy is converted to another form of energy. So here potential energy is maximum, kinetic energy is zero. In between, it contains both potential and kinetic energy. In the mean position, potential energy is zero as H is equal to zero. Kinetic energy is maximum. And in between, it contains both potential energy and kinetic energy. And at the extreme, potential energy is maximum and kinetic energy is zero. So potential energy is converted to kinetic. Again, kinetic to potential. So, this repeats when it oscillates. So, this is the verification of law of conservation of energy with the help of a simple pendulum. That energy can be transformed from one form to another form.